Welcome to this episode of YouTube, where I've entitled it Wolves to the Web, and how thankful we are for our supporters who watch these YouTubes, check out our wolf vlogs, check out our webcam, and do attend our webinars. So I'll be talking about webinars kind of towards the end here, but going to feature some footage from the exhibit. Again, one of the things that has been very appreciated is people following our Amazon wish list and providing us items that we desire. Well, I should say Luna desires, and one of them is pig's ears here, and Luna is demonstrating how wolves like to toss and scent roll. The pig's ears that we have chosen are all natural, so they've got a little bit of a different smell to them, and that stimulates the wolves to not only roll them, but for Luna to toss them. Certainly these small items of hides, certainly pig's ears are one of them that Luna seems to like to toss in the air, and you know, that gives the wolves great stimulus, and certainly is something that we always are mindful of in captivity, is the mental stimulation amongst the pack. And we are very happy to report the pack is doing quite well. They are getting along well with each other, and they are very well stimulated by the various treats that we have around the enclosure. So pig's ears are one of them, and that's one of the items that has been donated to us from the Amazon wish list. So we are thankful if you are one of the pig's ear donators. We do see, like I say, the wolves utilize those, and Luna is not the only one who will guard and possess them. Bolt's here, even though he's got a full, what we call a deer belly, meaning he ate his gross full of food. Wolves have the capability of eating up to 20% of their body weight, and so he's got a full belly of deer, and you can see the leftover deer skeleton is there in his bed. And we do use cover hay for beds, and again, that's another thankful donation from one of our special members who brings us cover hay. And even though he's got a full deer belly, Bolt takes the time to eat his pig's ear, and he will guard it from Denali. And we try to make sure that every time we give something that everybody has their own piece, so that we don't have too much competition over items. But it does occur, and Luna has been known to be our most possessive of all the wolves, and so she'll oftentimes try to display some behaviors that distract the other wolves and actually try to take things from them. But in this particular clip, everybody's getting along pretty well. Everybody has their own treat, and everybody's enjoying it. So again, as we get into the winter here, we're going to start using more of these cover hay beds to give the wolves a warm place to rest. And here's Bolts, who's stimulated to get up and investigate Aiden, who's scent rolling on a pig's ear. Now, it's not the pig's ear as much, that's the behavior of your dominant pack member that probably stimulated Bolts. Bolts, remember, is a three-year-old. He's looking for opportunities to move up in rank. So he does a four-leg stab there to Aiden, who's acting a little uncharacteristic of a dominant wolf by rolling around on his back in a subordinate posture. So Aiden is very quick to get up, reassert his position. Bolts gives him a respectful wide berth of about a foot there and decides that this is not the time to test the dominant male. So he goes back over to see if he can get his pig's ear. Again, scent rolling will stimulate that. So another opportunity here for Bolts to take a look at Aiden. Aiden's quick to get up. It's very hard if you're the dominant wolf to get any scent rolling, tossing, kind of fun involved, because the lower ranking wolves will look at it as an opportunity to test you. So Aiden finally gets to the point where he finishes rolling on the pig's ear and actually gets to eat it. And so that is, again, a drawback of being a pack leader, is you can't have a lot of that subordinate fun. And Luna, being a young pack leader, she could kind of get away with it. Here's another Luna clip. She's going to do what's called an invite chase. You notice she's pawed the ground. She did what we call as a play bow, kind of bowed her head and lowered her front body and then ran. And that invited Aiden to chase her. So this is what we call, like say, an invite chase. It's a social behavior. One wolf starts it. Aiden has been known to start it. Bolts is probably the least likely to start it because Bolts is trying to move up in rank, and oftentimes he doesn't necessarily want to stimulate the chase. But you can see Aiden clearly is getting very much more mobile. You know, he is responding well to some of the treatments that we've been doing, where we were concerned a little bit about his activity levels. He's definitely right in there with the pack. And also impressively, Luna is keeping up, and she has no signs that her right rear leg issues that she's had since we acquired her, she basically is dealing with quite well. Aiden, again, showing a raised leg urination there, showing that his status in the pack is intact as the dominant pack leader. And over to the east side, Grizzer is getting his pig's ear. You can't do anything here to the exhibit pack that Grizzer doesn't know about, and so equal opportunity for everyone. As a matter of fact, Grizzer will protest with biting at trees, slamming of gates. He certainly knows exactly what's going on in that exhibit pack, and I can't deny him his opportunity for a treat as well. So this is Grizzer in the front pack holding area, and we try to encourage him to go to the east side camera, but because he has been very interested in what's going on in the wolf yard, whether that be visits from Tina, whether that be staff in the yard, we are giving him a cover hay bed in the front pack holding area because he seems to be selecting that as his preference as a place to rest. From the surveillance camera, it does look like he does use the east side den here. So one thing that we have noticed is that we have reported there's less and less howling going on since Shadow's passing in July. The only thing we have noticed is that there seems to be a presence of wolves outside in the surrounding area that is about the only thing that stimulates the wolves to howl. And so we've been watching that from the surveillance cams, watching indications from Grizzer when he's sniffing the air and trying to, again, catch that scent. We typically know that there's probably something around the surrounding area. So that will stimulate oftentimes the wolves to mark, as well as wolf care staff working and bringing scent inside the enclosure will oftentimes result in the wolves doing an overbark where wolf care staff have sat or have walked or have left some kind of a sign that they've been there.
What are you standing on my box for?
So that's Grizzer's World, and again, we wanted to just announce that we will have another Wolves to the Web this week. In order to find the registration, you can go to our home site and go to the Visit tab and select the programs, and then scroll all the way down to November 1st to December 31st, and you'll see the program. It's called Wolves to the Web, and we obviously have a November 25th, as I said, Tuesday webinar, and December 22nd. The only difference is, because of daylight, we've had to move the webinar 1 hour earlier. So on the 25th, we will be at 4 p.m. Central Time. And on the 22nd of December, we will be at 3 p.m. And again, that's Central Time. And that's how we can be found. You can register right online. And typically what a webinar does is it has a live video footage right from the enclosure where I can interpret some of the behavior that's going on and certainly try to give some opinions on pack dynamics and status as we move into the winter of Luna and Boltz's third year. And I also try to give some updates about Grizzer, but Grizzer will be actually having his own webinar live from the east side in May, on May 5th, on Cinco de Mayo, on his birthday. For this month, I'd like to spend a little time personally thanking all of the donors who have supported our Ambassador Wolves this year, and so I'll have a little tribute at the end that identifies every wolf that I have worked with here since 1989 here at the center, and a short thank you to those people who have helped make everything we do here possible. So that's it for this week's YouTube. Thanks again, and hope to see you on the webinar on Tuesday.